Moyo una dunda.
Yo.
Wagwan,
Wagwan. Of course, make some more noise for Bravo Africa. Yeah, of course, introducing a Bravo Africa. Like, are you even Kenyan or Jamaican?
Yes, man, we have the whole set of locks.
You have the whole what?
Yes, we have the whole set of locks. The vibe and the Caribbean vibe as well. So.
Yeah, yes, nice.
You know, before we even go too far into this, like, class is in session, all right?
Yeah.
It's time to get to have Nini B in school right now. I want you to teach us, like, really simple, at least, like, two phrases.
Both of them.
Two phrases, like a whole sentence.
Like a whole sentence?
Yeah.
What you want to know about in a part, what kind of stuff?
How about I really love your music?
You can see.
Uh-huh.
Really love your music, you know.
Me really love your music.
Yes, yeah. Man, you just need to give
your music,
it.
Like the part of vibe.
Yeah, you just give it there.
A little
vibe thing.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? Just the same thing, just the same vibe you say,
yeah.
I really love your music, or I really like your music.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
When you put it in a part of kind of setup, you say, I really love your music, you know.
Your music, big time. It's like a song.
When you talk, it's a song.
Yeah.
When somebody talk and you just put in an instrumental and there is a relic, it's a song, it's a music.
Nice.
Nice, man. Yeah, I'm loving this. Don't say that on here, your brother.
So yeah, anyway. Are you from Kenya? Born and raised?
Yes, man.
Like, where's the accent coming?
I always tell people, like, Bravo is a Kenyan born.
Uh-huh.
Like, Bravo is a Kenyan born, but I have a Jamaican blood running in me.
Yeah.
I don't know how that came. Maybe my dad is a Jamaican. I don't know.
It's
a long story. Uh-huh. I don't know.
So it's Jamaican blood brought upon yourself.
Yes, man. This just that Caribbean vibe thing and thing, the dancehall aspect.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That really motivates me. That really, you know what I mean? When I'm in that zone, I think the Bravo monster just come out, like, you know what I mean? The realest way.
Yeah,
the realest way.
Anything.
So when you look at the Kenyan dancehall thing, like, right now, you see we have, like, many people are playing with the music. Like, people ain't serious in the industry. You understand? What do you think about that?
Like, people are not serious.
We don't
need to generalize everybody.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of people who are really putting in work out there, you know what I mean? And them really need some great recognition and support.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
On the other hand, we have some wannabe kind of artists who are just flocking up the entertainment scene.
Uh-huh.
It's a pity that they have, you know what I mean, the resources, they have everything. Uh-huh.
So
they are the one that you will be seeing everywhere. Mm-hmm. So. And the realest one, like, you know what I mean, the people who are really doing some great work in pushing the Kenyan entertainment music ahead. I mean, kind of don't get the full support they need, but it's a good look still.
True.
We give thanks in. We just need to keep on doing what we do best.
Mm-hmm. True.
The likes of you guys bringing us on shore and just to entertain, we give people some real vibe them like and thing. It's a good look.
It's a good look.
Yeah.
And something else. My question was, like, right now, Mr. Chronix is coming home in Kenya, and you see we have all of them reggae artists in Kenya,
great,
man.
It's great.
But the people kind of raising for him, you understand? Exactly.
Let me tell you, from my point of view, as a reggae dancehall artist, you know, I know at the end of the day it's business for somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
The promoter
that
might not be a reggae fan or a dancehall fan.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
To him, he's after business.
Mm-hmm.
He's looking on the business aspect. Mm-hmm. So him don't want to know, like, whether he'll have blah, blah, blah artists. Mm-hmm. See?
Yeah.
So that's good on him. But the kind of part that I really dislike the most is that the guy sponsoring the event are using the reggae dancehall promoters to promote the song. And the reggae dancehall promoters know that there's a lot of reggae dancehall young artists here in Kenya.
Yeah.
See?
Mm-hmm.
A real dancehall reggae artist.
Mm-hmm.
But they can bring forth, or they can present them dead and tell the promoters, yo, it's good you're bringing Chronix, but we also have our own reggae and dancehall, so let's build this culture.
Right.
See?
Right.
Let's give the platform to reggae artists.
Yeah.
It's a pity, like, you will see somebody else, I don't want to call names,
mm-hmm.
someone else who is different from another part of the kind of, you know what I mean, different sphere, is coming to entertain the dancehall fans. So it's kind of, it doesn't make sense.
True.
You don't see, when Rick Ross, for example, came, you didn't see, like, other reggae dancehall artists going.